Today we will be studying about a very serious pest, red cotton bug. Its scientific name is Dysdercus cingulatus. Host plant is cotton. Other than that, it also feeds on other members of Malvaceae family. Identification marks. How you are going to identify whether it is a red cotton bug? So for that, this is the diagram showing adult of a red cotton bug. So normal antenna, 3 pairs of legs, wings, usual insect parts. Okay. Other than that, typical character is whole body is red in color. Whole body is red in color. Four wings have black dots. Center of the four wing has black dot. Alright. Anal segment, legs, antenna, eyes and scutellum are black. Otherwise, rest of the body is blood red in color or bright red in color. Female lives for about 60 days. So, lifespan of female is 60 days. In this period of 60 days, the female can lay 800 to 900 eggs. But she doesn't lay all the eggs at the same time. Eggs are laid in batches of 100 at a interval. Alright. Now, the size of the female, size of the bug is 12 to 15 millimeter in length. It is good flyer. Very good flyer. When you shake the cotton plant, then they fall on the ground and they also crawl very fast on the ground. The next point is life cycle. So the adult female lays a batch of 100 eggs in moist soil or in plant debris. Okay, because the eggs need moisture to hatch, and even the first instar nymph need moisture to survive. It is very essential. Therefore, eggs are laid in moist soil or moist plant debris. Okay, size of the egg is 1.5 to 0.9 millimeter. Eggs when laid are yellow in color. Later on, they become orange in color. Eggs take around 5 to 8 days to hatch and the first instar nymph comes out. Life cycle shows hemimetaboly, or it is called as incomplete metamorphosis. So you can see only egg, nymph and adult. Alright. So first instar nymph does not feed on anything. It simply aggregates near the empty cotton balls and remains like that only. Moisture is very essential for its survival. Later on, after successive molting, the second instar, third instar, nymph are formed. They are voracious feeder. They feed gregariously on the seeds of cotton. They feed on the cotton balls. Okay. Then next, further molting, you get the fourth instar and the fifth instar nymph. These nymphs, they leave their place and move about all over the plant and they feed on different cotton balls, thus destroying all the cotton balls. Okay, the fifth instar nymph is the last instar, after which it metamorphoses into the adult. The nymph looks like the adult with the only difference it does not have wings. Adults have wings. Nymphs do not have wings. Alright. So the last instar, fifth instar nymph, if you see, it has small black wing pads which will later on form the wings. The size of the fifth instar nymph is 10 to 13 millimeter, almost equivalent to that of the adult. Now we move on to the next point, and that is damage caused by red cotton bug. Okay, both the nymph as well as the adult, they feed on the sac of leaves, shoot and bonds of cotton. Because of this, the plant shows stunted growth. The balls that are formed are smaller in size. The quantity of oil in the seeds also decreases. Then the lint that you get from these cotton balls are stained yellow to red in color. This is because of the Nematospora gossypii, which is injected by red cotton bug when they are feeding on the plant sap. Okay, so further, if infestation is too much, then the green cotton balls turn brown and they die. The last point is control measures. So control measures are those measures which are taken to stop or to prevent the infestation of the pest. Okay, so first method is the mechanical method. In mechanical method, we can do hand picking. So here the person has to carry water or kerosinized water in a container, and he or she has to pick personally each and every adult or nymph and put it in the kerosinized water to kill it. Okay, otherwise what you can do is you can go for plowing also, plow the land so that the eggs which are there in the soil, moist soil, they will come up, they will come in contact with eggs and light, they will dry and will be destroyed. Then chemical control, you can go for carboryl spray, you can go for 35cc endosulfane, then dusting of DHC or DDT 5%, they are quite effective. Then biological control, what is biological control? Controlling of one organism using another biological organism is called as biological control of pest. So here herpetofactor postalis is used as a biological agent. It is a predator of the nymph as well as adult of red cotton bug. Other than that, chicken can also be used. Around 15 chicken can be used to control 0.1 hectare land of cotton crop from red cotton bug infestation. These chickens you can put in a cage having trolley, and you can rotate in the field in different places, or you can leave the chicken like that only in the field. So this is about red cotton bug.